So instrumentation, I try and do as much as possible before I seat the restoration. And the key element for me to consider is the power or the handpiece that we use for the adjustment. In the laboratory, we work with laboratory handpieces, not operatory handpieces. So we have to have an appreciation that the laboratory handpieces run at a maximum of 40,000 RPM. And in fact, technicians, ceramists in particular, when we grind on ceramic, we're typically in the range of 10 to maybe 20,000, but typically in the range of 10 to 15,000 RPMs. So the power of the handpiece is critical. It's a slow speed, and my recommendation will be for an electric handpiece to maintain the torque at slow speed. That's where the efficiency will come in. We'll talk about the diamond burrs to use, and the strong suggestion will be fine diamonds, and then the rubber wheels. So if you think about what's happening extraorally, it's no different than what would happen in the laboratory. Again, if you're doing in-office milling, you're doing probably some of these procedures as routine. But if you're not doing in-office milling, many clinicians are almost afraid to grind on or adjust ceramic because we're uncertain on how to manage the technique. So, first suggestion, do as much out of the mouth as possible. The maximum speed I would use of a fine grit diamond would be 20,000 RPMs, but I normally set my rheostat to max out at 15,000 RPM. The slower the speed, the less trauma that will be put into the ceramic, and the suggestion will be a fine grit diamond burr, so the scratches on the surface we kept to a minimum. We want a light touch to avoid heat and vibration. If you use an electric handpiece and bear down on the surface, that can generate more trauma, more energy, and generate more heat. And cracks may occur just because of the heat, not only because of the diamonds that are being used. And then the polishing that we go through with a sequence of rubber wheels, the maximum speed I'll use the polishers is at 10,000 RPMs. Normally, we're probably in the 5,000 to 8,000 RPMs, but I see a maximum will be 10,000 RPMs. I mentioned bilayered ceramic. So if we have lithium to silicon, we have e.max ceram over the surface. Now that's a glass ceramic, but it handles very much the same as a feldspathic material. And so depending on your restoration, anteriorly or posteriorly, your interproximal contacts may be glass ceramic, not the lithium to silicate. So keys here are we want to mark the interdental contact. We try never to use a diamond burr. I typically will use a white universal polishing wheel. The products I'll be mentioning are from Brasler. They have a nice series of polishing wheels, and I stay within a system to gain predictability. I always look for other options, but I've been using Brasler products for my entire career, and I find them to be very effective. So I'm going to be referring to various wheels that I use within their system. And I achieve the high shine with a gray dialyte to achieve the highest luster. So first, marking the interproximal contact, we typically would use articulating paper. AccuFilm 2 is the one that I would use because it's extremely thin. To get it to mark on glazed porcelain, though, I take a little Vaseline on my rubber gloves, wipe it onto the articulating paper, and then it transfers the mark a little bit easier to the interproximal. The other material I use that I find even more effective than the AccuFilm 2 is also AccuFilm, but it's AccuFilm 4. You paint on the surface. It's like a whiteout material for those of you who remember typewriters and the whiteout material. So you paint it on the surface. It's extremely thin. When you put it in the mouth, it'll leave one little spot that it rubs on, and then you can go through your adjusting process. So with the adjusting process interproximally, I said I try to avoid using diamond burrs because that leaves a rougher surface. So my first choice would always be a polishing wheel, like the White Universal Polishing Wheel. This product has been available from Brasseler for probably 30 years. That's how long I've been using it. So after the White Universal Polishing Wheel, you can transition to the pink rubber wheel. This is not a pink dialyte. It's just a little bit, cuts a little bit smoother than the white, but many times I can transition from the white polishing wheel to the gray dialyte. The numbers you can see here. So if you have an interest in pursuing finding them, you have a reference number. So here I'm going to demonstrate, now that I have the interproximal contact mark, I'm going to use the white polishing wheel and with gentle pressure, rapporting about 8,000 RPMs, I'm manipulating that edge of the white polishing wheel on the surface. And you can take several tenths of a millimeter of ceramic off in a matter of 5 to 10 seconds. Now I'm just shaping a little bit to prevent just a flat area. So I'm trying to round those edges slightly so it's more anatomically correct. After I've accomplished that, I change to the gray dialyte. And because the previous surface has left it quite smooth, the gray dialyte, in a matter of a very short period of time, can create a glass smooth surface. So in a matter of using two wheels, I can cut efficiently, so I don't need a diamond wheel. The white cuts efficiently but leaves a smooth surface, and the gray dialyte creates a glass smooth surface, which will be kind to the natural tooth next to it or if there's adjacent ceramic restoration. So I would handle felspathic or glass ceramic materials with these particular wheels. Once again, I'm mentioning this because e.max lithium disilicate can be layered, and if it is interproximally frequently, it is layered in that area.